Hello, friends, and welcome back to r/ProRevenge. Today we have another set of great stories about crazy people and their revenge. Our first story, she moved out the next week. So this all happened about 15 years ago, give or take, when I was still a kid living at home. We had a house with a huge backyard in the suburbs, and the neighboring property next to our driveway was a set of three attached rental flats, each with their front door facing our house. We were usually good friends with most of our neighbors, the flats next door included. After the family in the middle flat left, an older single woman moved in. She was home more often than not, so I doubt she had a job, and she wasn't particularly friendly. She kept to herself, which is fine, and never really acknowledged any of the neighbors. Whatever, that's cool. So one Saturday around midday, I was out back with a lawnmower, earning myself some pocket money. Big yard, so about 20 minutes in, I was about halfway done, and suddenly a noise control officer knocks on the door. Tells us to hurry it up. They'd received a complaint. And though they thought it was ridiculous, they had to say something. Bit stupid, but whatever. Now, we weren't a loud family, not at all. No parties, no screaming, nothing like that. Over the next month, we kept getting visits from noise control. Always during the day, mind you. We'd get visits for mowing the lawn. Even had a couple of complaints about my younger sister and I playing and hanging out in the backyard on weekends or in the afternoon after school. Again, we weren't all that loud. At the time, we would have been about 13. So more often than not, the boy next door and I would just be chilling on the swings, talking. Not loud, just being outside. Now, we'd never had an issue with noise, and none of our other neighbors ever had a problem. We'd never had noise control called before. So we asked around. It was fairly obvious at this point that the snobby cow that had moved into the flat next door was doing all the complaining. My father would always stock up on firewood in the summer to prepare for the winter, and would have to chop it up himself. So the first weekend of chopping for the year, it's like 2 p.m. on a Saturday, pulls out his old chainsaw, and it's on for about a minute and a half at most before he realizes the chain needs replaced. He turns it off, grabs the axe, and proceeds to chop wood the long way. Next thing we know, noise control shows up. The officers are sick of having to visit at this point, and were pretty friendly with Dad by now. Turns out that, yes, it was the new neighbor next door. It also turned out that she'd been an issue for them for a while and that the noise control was well aware of her stupid complaints from all of her previous addresses. Unfortunately, they were legally obligated to follow through with them. Next weekend, surprise, surprise. We get a visit after the dad's been chopping more wood with the axe because the chainsaw was out of action. At this point, he decides, F it. Why not give her something to actually complain about? A family friend of ours happened to be a truck driver. He drives a big rig, almost Optimus Prime level, up and down the country. He also happened to be back in town that weekend. We give him a ring, and he's keen to help us out. Next step is to warn all the other neighbors who were all fully on board because, as it turns out, we weren't the only ones she was complaining about. Proceed to the next weekend, about 9 a.m. We spend about half an hour getting this great big truck down our driveway. It was a pretty wide driveway, but it was a pretty wide truck too, so it was a damn tight squeeze. Now, having been good friends with the previous neighbors, we were familiar with the internal layout of these flats. The bedrooms were directly next to their front doors, facing our driveway. We managed to get the cab of this massive truck far enough into the driveway to be directly next to this B-word's bedroom. There's about a meter and a half separating the truck and her wall. Perfect. On goes the horn. Loud as hell. Terrifies our cats. On it goes again. And again. And then us kids get a turn. You could hear that thing a block away. Did it for about 10 minutes. Go inside for coffee. Come back out. Run the horn one more time for good measure before our friend takes off. This time, there were no noise control officers. No complaints. Nothing. She left the next week. She learned what real noise was, and she ran out of complaints. And our second story. I just wanted my deposit back. So about 10 years ago, my wife, then girlfriend, and I decided to move in together. She was sick of living in a dorm, and my lease was up, and we had a family friend that was looking for someone to move into a little granny flat under their house. I say under because they lived on a steep hill where the flat was below the house with an entrance on the backside. So we had this incredible view out the back, a pool, we'll get to that insane thing, fire pit, etc. And the rent was in our price range. And the landlord, let's call her Mary, even dropped it $100 if we did some yard work, skimmed the pool, etc. Oh, my parents own a couple of rentals and have my whole life, and I've done maintenance for them and even attended a couple of court cases as well with them. This will come into play later. Everything was great for a couple of months. Then Mary and her wife start fighting. Screaming matches, stomping above us, throwing things. I didn't understand how people could be that mad at each other that often and still be together. I eventually sent them an email saying we were not comfortable with the fighting and we wanted to make sure they were okay. They replied to that with, "You're lucky you have a place this nice." Mary began to scrutinize the yard and pool work I was doing, to the point that she would insist I vacuum and skim the saltwater pool with no chemicals. Saltwater pools need far less chlorine than regular ones, but they still need some. She wanted me to stop mowing and use a weed whacker only because the mower was getting old and tired, real petty things. The last straw was when a driver was shot in a gang shooting across the street. We decided to cut our losses and get out of there. Found a new apartment and a roommate, one of my wife's college friends, that was open a month later, perfect for us. We were on a month-to-month on this place. Emailed Mary that we were moving out in 30 days, etc. At that point, she went insane. Tried to do daily inspections of the granny flat, would call and email daily with chores around the property, insisting that we do. She would pound on her floor, our ceiling, every time she heard so much as a whisper. Daily inspections would require 24-hour notice. She never gave that. Then she tried to bring potential renters over to see the flat. We flat out told her to go away when that happened with no notice. Finally, 2 weeks before move out, she had a pest control guy stop by when I was at work and my wife was in class. Our cat was home alone, and we got the notice about spraying pesticide from her in a text about the same time the guy started. So I rush home after work, stop by upstairs, and ask for a copy of the pest control receipt. I have massive allergies to most pesticides, so I need to know what was used. She goes into her office and brings back a copy with every single chemical on the list checked off. Every single one. I immediately take the copy, run down, grab the cat and a handful of clothes, and drive to my parents' house. We stayed there for 4 days, hoping everything would clear out in time for us to finish packing and cleaning. The last couple days before move out, Mary was out of town, and we were able to get it completely finished a day early. We even patched nail holes, painted, cleaned the carpet. My mom came and helped us get everything ready for the next tenants. It was immaculate, and we took photos and video of everything. When Mary did the checkout with us, we said we weren't comfortable being there without filming, legal to do, and she did a short walkthrough, saying it was fine, but that her copier was broken and she'd have to email us the final copy. 2 days later, we get a copy with $1,400 in damages claimed above our deposit, including a number of charges like, my wife had to replace a screw in a cabinet, $1 for screw, $15 for labor. I was livid. The place was spotless. My mother, a landlord who does all her own prep work and rentals, helped us, and we'd been very non-confrontational except for filming the walkthrough. I'd kept every email, text, and letter from them and started to put together a small claims case. I figured she'd already be doing the same. Luckily, I knew my tenants' rights and that she'd violated them a lot, including email chains where I'd point out 24-hour notice laws, etc. In emails, she'd reply to them. Finally, I called the exterminator. The conversation went like this. Hi, you sprayed in my flat without my permission because my landlord ordered it with no notice to me with my cat inside and used every chemical on your receipt? We most certainly did not. Here's a copy of the work order. We only put out ant traps on the outside. Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you for your clarification. Armed with that last little piece, I countersued, asking for a bad faith penalty as well as our deposit. Bad faith was 3 times deposit, so I was asking for a total of 4 times what we'd given Mary on move-in. The big day came in court. I showed up early, had everything in order and ready, and she swaggers in, huffed up, and clearly ready to put me in my place. We sat outside the courtroom for about 20 minutes until a courtroom worker asked the waiting room if anyone would be willing to go to mediation instead since they were booked solid. We both say yes and go into a mediation room with an arbitrator whose job was just to keep us civil and answer any legal questions they could while staying neutral. Mary lays out her case. It takes about 4 minutes. The arbitrator looked very neutral still. Then I present my case, bringing up each violation, each lie, and end it with the work order from the exterminator, both copies. At this point, the arbitrator looks visibly upset, and I can tell they were just trying to stay neutral. Mary then asks them, why is he asking for 4 times the deposit? The arbitrator then explains the bad faith penalty. Then she looks at me, would you be okay dropping the penalty for your deposit back? Sure. They looked over at Mary. I can't tell you what to do, but what I can say is if you decide to go back into the courtroom in front of the judge, it's likely not going to go in your favor. I swear they really said this. I know they're not supposed to, but they did. I got my deposit back. And our last story. Neighbors call the fire department on my first fire, so we start two more. Last night, I decided to have a fire with a few of my friends. I made sure to check the county website to see if we had a fire ban on. Everything was fine. We had a small radio playing in the background. The level of noise was low enough that we could talk without having to raise our voices, and there were four of us, so not a loud occasion at all. Anyway, about 45 minutes in, we hear a loud diesel engine running just out front. I go to see who it is, and two men in full gear are walking towards me. I'm flabbergasted. They tell me one of my neighbors called and said my house was on fire. I know exactly which neighbors they are because they've done this before, and I can see them through their back window staring at us. So due to the fact that I don't have a fire grate, I can't keep the fire going because of the county bylaws. My fireplace is not suitable for use due to the fact that it's got some loose rocks. True, it's in rough shape. So we shut it down, and I tell my mom. She informs me that we have not one, but two more fireplaces, both equipped with grates. So we start two new fires. Within an hour, the department's back. They're ready to find me, but they see that everything's all good and up to code, so they leave. We proceed to turn up the radio and make the fires big and keep on going till 1 a.m. Hey guys, thank you all for watching the video to the end, and I'll see you in the next one.